From being released from prison on drug and gun charges on the summer of 2016 to being established as a formidable figure in hip-hop by the end of 2018, Little Baby released 7 full-length bodies of music and a slew of hit singles. Little Baby's rise has been so rapid, after all, his debut album came out just over 4 years ago, that his numbers can be so perplexing to those who haven't been following the rapper's career closely. Little Baby has become a mainstream celebrity. Since the release of his debut album, Harder Than Ever, in May of 2018, Little Baby has become one of hip-hop's most sought-after rappers. The Atlanta, Georgia rapper has had multiple chart-topping hits, including Drake's Yes Indeed and Gunna's Drip Too Hard, which have made him not only a multi-million dollar recording artist, but also a certified multi-platinum artist. Since the beginning of his career, Little Baby has gone platinum more than 10 times, which is quite impressive to say at least. But what makes Little Baby's story even more incredible is that when he was only 18 years old, he was sitting alone in a 6x8 concrete cell in a Georgia State prison. There are certainly some parts of his career that Little Baby doesn't like to talk about. Today, we're talking about the crime life Little Baby's trying to keep secret. Keep on watching the video to find out more about Little Baby's crime life. Early life. Lil Baby was arrested for the first time when he was only 12 years old. Lil Baby had the audacious idea to break into and rob a house in his Atlanta neighborhood while he was out with his friends. As a group approached the house, police appeared out of nowhere and arrested everyone on the spot. After a few minutes of questioning, the cops concluded that Lil Baby and his friends were planning to break in and arrested them for burglary. Because Lil Baby was only 12 at the time, he couldn't be booked into a county jail, so he was taken to a local juvenile detention center where he was held only for 10 days. Lil Baby continued to be involved with the streets after he was released, the only difference being that he was less discreet about it. Before his arrest, no one really knew what he was up to except for his friends, but after he was arrested, everyone including his mother was well aware of his bad intentions. Despite being knee-deep in the streets, Little Baby continued to go to school and claimed to be academically gifted. He consistently passed all of his classes and was well on his way to earning his high school diploma, but he was eventually expelled from high school due to his repeated suspensions throughout his academic career. Lil Baby was planning on attending an alternative school after being kicked out, but after realizing he was too old for the alternative school, he decided to drop out. Now he was a full-time street hustler, and with all his newfound free time, Lil Baby was arrested several times between the ages of 16 and 17. Because Lil Baby was still a minor at the time, the details of these arrests still appeared to be somewhat sealed, but he stated in a few interviews early in his career that the arrests were all for the same two things, drugs and guns. Lil Baby seemed to get away with almost no consequences every time he was arrested. But this couldn't last forever, as Lil Baby's next arrest enraged a judge who sentenced him to probation. Lil Baby stayed out of trouble while on probation for a short time, but when he turned 18, he slipped up again and he was sent back to jail after violating his probation. Lil Baby was facing serious prison time as a result of his probation violation, so he needed to hire a lawyer as soon as possible. His first lawyer was able to get him a deal where he would only have to serve 2 years in prison, but Lil Baby wouldn't take no for an answer and fired him to hire a new lawyer who was able to get him an even better deal where he could attend a 6-month program instead of going to prison. Little Baby agreed to the deal and began attending the program a few days later. After arriving at the program, Little Baby quickly discovered that the program was intended to last a year rather than the 6 months he had been told. This frustrated Little Baby and made him feel quite duped, but he persisted in giving the program another chance, and he was then kicked out of the program and sentenced to 2 years in prison after getting into a fight with another program attendee just a few days later. Little Baby didn't have the difficulties that you might expect an 18-year-old to have in prison because he had cousins serving life sentences in the same prison he was in. Aside from having some family by his side, it's likely that his 2-year sentence was the shortest of all the inmates, making him grateful that he'll be able to be released anyway, whereas other inmates would never see the light of day again. Beginning of his rap career. Lil Baby was released from prison on July 1st, 2016 and returned to his mother's home in Atlanta. When Lil Baby returned, he discovered that many of his street friends, including Marlo and Young Thug, had started rapping and were causing quite a stir in the industry. While this was all and well, Lil Baby had no desire to rap and intended to return to his old habits of hustling in the streets. When word of Lil Baby's plan got out, old friends like P and Coach K from Quality Control, as well as Young Thug, encouraged him to start rapping instead of returning to his old ways. Lil Baby started toying with the idea right away, but it wasn't until Young Thug paid for Lil Baby's first studio session that actually got him started. Lil Baby's life was forever changed just after that one studio session with Young Thug. Lil Baby soon began working non-stop in the studio, recording song after song until he finally released his debut project, Perfect Timing, which featured Lil Yachty, Gunna, and of course, Young Thug. This project generated a lot of buzz for Lil Baby, not only because of the good music, but also because everyone found out who Quality Control's new artist was. Lil Baby took advantage of the newfound attention and released his debut album, Harder Than Ever, shortly after. Two of the album's tracks, My Dog and Freestyle, went viral online, propelling Lil Baby to mainstream success. This not only allowed him to collaborate with his friends at Quality Control to create incredible hits, but it also allowed him to collaborate with other top-tier artists such as Drake. Consequently, Drake and Lil Baby's song, Yes Indeed, topped Billboard Streaming Songs chart and peaked number 6 on the US Billboard Hot 100, making it Lil Baby's first top 10 hits. It's also cool that Gunna, who was also featured on Lil Baby's first project, began to achieve mainstream success around the same exact time as Lil Baby. The two eventually collaborated on an album called Drip Harder, with the lead single, Drip Too Hard, reaching number 4 on the Billboard charts and going platinum 5 times. During his rap journey, then, on February 7, 2019, at around 6 p.m., Lil Baby was riding around his orange Corvette when a Georgia State Trooper saw the rapper fail to signal while changing lanes. Lil Baby then proceeded to speed up and pass other vehicles recklessly while a large number of pedestrians walked by. When the State Trooper approached Lil Baby's Corvette to pull him over, Baby realized what was going on and began to accelerate and change lanes in an attempt to avoid being pulled over. Lil Baby was eventually pulled over and arrested for failing to signal while changing lanes, reckless driving, and attempting to flee or elude police. Baby was then loaded into the back of the police cruiser before being taken to the Fulton County Jail. Later that night, Lil Baby was released after posting bail for an undisclosed amount of money. There have been no updates in the media regarding this arrest, but it is assumed that Lil Baby was only required to pay a fine and possibly attend traffic school. The Atlanta native flaunted his newfound lifestyle and shut down naysayers with ease in some of Baby's early hits. From Yes Indeed to Drip Too Hard, his braggadocio is effortless and a core part of his appeal. However, following the release of My Turn, the song Emotionally Scarred, which became a top 40 hit, demonstrated Baby's storytelling abilities, which he had not previously highlighted. The track is riddled with personal wounds and balances anecdotes with open-hearted apologies, and is marked by a lifting pan flute. My Turn's linchpin, Emotionally Scarred, amplified the complexities of an artist trying to make the transition from hip-hop star to household name. During the George Floyd protests in June 12, 2020, Lil Baby released the political song The Bigger Picture. The song was also Lil Baby's highest charting song as a lead artist, debuting at number 3 on the Billboard Hot 100. We Paid, which featured 42 Doug and appeared on the My Turn Deluxe, also charted on the top 10. Pop Smoke covered Lil Baby's For the Night from his posthumous debut album Shoot for the Stars, Aim for the Moon in July 2020. It peaked at number 6 on the Billboard Hot 100. My Turn was the first album of the year to be certified double platinum by the Recording Industry Association of America in September 2020. At the 63rd Annual Grammy Awards, The Bigger Picture received 2 nominations, Best Rap Performance and Best Rap Song. Lil Baby has been nominated for 3 Grammy Awards, 2 American Music Awards, 2 MTV Music Awards, and 7 BET Awards over the course of his career. At the Apple Music Awards 2020, he was named the biggest all-genre artist of the year. Reflecting back, Lil Baby claims that he never wants to go back to prison and has proven to everyone that he is not only a gifted artist but also has a strong work ethic. He seemed to realize how fortunate he was to be able to be surrounded by well-known rappers and label executives, and he poured his heart and soul into the music until he became one of hip-hop's biggest names. Despite being one of the industry's biggest artists, Lil Baby knows what it's like to be at the bottom, having spent nearly 2 years in prison at the age of only 19 on weapon and drug charges. In an interview with NPR, the Atlanta rapper discussed his time in prison and expressed his dissatisfaction with the use of incarceration to teach people a lesson. "Prison is just putting you in a room," he explained. "How does that help you become a better member of society? What does that mean in terms of assisting you in changing? To me, being in prison makes you worse. You're not wearing a leash around your neck, but you are wearing handcuffs around your wrist. You're not in a dog cage. Instead, you're in a human cage that's not much larger than a dog cage. You live where you use the bathroom. They feed you when they feel like it. When they tell you to eat, you eat. It's almost if I'm a dog." Well, that's the end of today's video. If you enjoyed the video, be sure that you hit the like button and comment below. Also, please don't forget to subscribe and hit the notification bell if you're new to the channel and you want to be notified whenever we upload more content. Thanks again for watching.